We welcome in Ryan Spooner. You went for a ride along with Abdul Abdi. What a cool experience this is. We'll talk hockey momentarily. What was the best part of that?
Honestly, for me, I did a ride along probably 3 years ago when I was in too, and it was kind of nice just to kind of get out there and just help out, to see some stuff that I'm not kind of used to seeing. And, you know, it was kind of a humbling experience for me. You know, there's a lot of people out there that are in need, and I just tried to help out with that. And it was definitely good for me, you know. Since I've been a kid, I've always wanted to be a cop. And I was lucky to have the chance to just go out there and just kind of experience what they kind of go through. And it was good. So, yeah.
So then if you must have respect for authority, you want to be a cop. If we pulled the referees, we would know that you don't say a word to them at all year long, right? Because the respect for the uniform and authority. Is that right, Ryan?
Yeah, I mean, I think the most Tims I've had in a year, I think, is 16 since being in the NHL. And last year, I had two. So,
all right.
You know, I've definitely never been much of a violent guy.
He's a law and order kind of guy, Tony.
And we know you got excited when we knew we were going to talk to him, because when you got to the Rangers, you wasted no time making an impact. Why were you so effective coming down the stretch after coming over in that trade deadline deal?
Honestly, I was just trying to have fun. I mean, when I heard the news I was going to be traded, I was a little bit upset. You know, I was with the same team for 5 years, and a lot of guys on the team I kind of grew a lot closer with. So that was tough to hear. But at the same time, too, it was a fresh start for me. And I went to the Rangers, and the guys were awesome with me, and the coaching staff, too, and all that kind of stuff. So I just wanted to help out. I just went out there, tried to play my game, and just tried to have fun. So that's what I did.
It's amazing what a little fun can do, eh, Ryan? Now, we talked about you before on the way in. You can play center. You can play wing. You've played both at the NHL and had varying degrees of success at each position. Which do you prefer, and which one do you think you'll be playing with the Rangers this year?
That's a good question. I mean, I played center since I've been, like, two. So yeah. I played wing for maybe 60 games since I've been pro. There's pros and cons to both. I mean, I've kind of struggled with my face-offs. I think last year I was a lot better. I tried to work on them, but it's always been something that I've lacked on. So that being said, you know, for me to go over to wing, that kind of took the burden off of that. But I can play center. I mean, I think with the Rangers, I would like to play center there. But if they want me to play wing, that's fine by me. And, you know, if they need me to play center, then that's fine by me too. So.
We know these decisions are going to weigh on the mind of the new bench boss of the Rangers, David Quinn. Your impressions of him to this point, he certainly has gotten a lot of attention since he accepted that role.
Yeah, he gave me a call about a month ago, and we kind of just chatted there. And basically what he said to me was, we have a young team this year, and he expects that we work hard and that we're in great shape. And I think as a young team, I think that if we're in really good shape and we just go out there and we skate, that's a recipe for us to be a successful team. So he definitely knows what he's doing, and I'm excited to play for him. So
it's funny you say we have a young team. You're kind of in between, 26 years old. Do you consider yourself a young player or a veteran?
I mean, I'm definitely not young anymore, but I'm definitely not old. I mean, I think the fact that I came from the Bruins, the leadership group that they have there, just the things that I've learned throughout my time there, I think that can help me out. And especially with a team that we're definitely not going to be really young, but we're not going to be old. I think I can help out and try to lead by example and just go out there and just have some fun. So. Yeah,
and congrats on the new contract, 2 years, $4 million per. That's a little bit of security for you as well. Well-earned and well done.
Thank you.
And Rangers fans like you in the Broadway blue shirt, but we all want to see you just one more time in the uniform.
Yeah.
How cool was it to wear that?
I didn't actually dress up, but it was definitely cool just to kind of go out there and just see what they do. And a lot of people think that they're just giving out tickets and all that kind of stuff. But in the day that I was there, we went to an old age home, and we talked with some of the people there. Yeah. And stopped to them and just talked, and then we went to the mall once to kind of just walk through there. We didn't get a call for a couple hours, and we kind of talked with some people here and there, and helping out kids here and there, and just little things like that where some people need a little bit of support, and you know, you're there for them, and you can help them out. So you know, that was definitely good.
Well said. A great way to spend your summer. Congrats again on the deal. As Johnny said, thanks for joining us and good luck this season.
Thanks.